Hey, Jason Morrell here. Now, line charts are a very popular chart type, and they're really good for showing the trend of your data. The first thing I'm going to do is to start with the data that I want to use to produce the chart. So I'm going to select the names here, including the heading, hold down Control, and select all 4 years' worth of data over here. Now, the reason I've included the headings is because those labels there are going to be used for the legend in just a second. Again, I could press F11, but that always produces a column chart as a starting point. To save a bit of time, I'm going to go straight to Insert here, find the Line option, and in the gallery there, choose any sort of line chart that I like. Let's start with a simple one to start off with. I'm going to put it on its own chart by choosing Move Chart here, New Sheet, and let's call it Line. With this line chart here, you can see it's quite cluttered. So down the bottom on the axis, we have the various people. In the legend, we have the 4 years all color-coded. Having the data in this format, let's say we look at Bill Gates here, we have the four values, his net worth values, over the last 4 years, each one represented with a different color. This actually is probably the wrong way to present this data at this stage. So instead, if we come up to the top where it says switch row and column, it switches the names with the years, and you end up with something like this. So each of these lines belongs to one person. Again, there's so many people on this one chart, it's hard to make sense of what's happening. So I'm going to simplify this just a little bit, and concentrate on just a handful of people, and then we could do some stuff with the lines themselves. So I'm going to come to Filter. This shows you all the people and all the years. I'm going to trim this list down and just concentrate on Bill, Jeff, and Mark. Click Apply, and so now I've only got three lines on my chart. It's a lot easier to work with. At any stage, I can introduce these other people back in if I wanted to. When you look at the lines, they're very jerky because it's drawing straight lines between each of your data points. The first thing I like to do with my line charts is to smooth out the line. And the way I do that is like this. If I right-click on any line and choose Format the Data Series, that displays the panel on the right-hand side with all your options for various chart elements. For this one, I'm going to go to the Label options here. And to smooth the line out, I come to the bottom of the options and just tick the box that says Smooth Line. And it smooths out all those jerky straight lines that we had before, and it gives you a much nicer appearance on the chart. Unfortunately, each line has to be done separately. But thankfully, while the panel's open here, all you've got to do is to click on each line, so it has the focus, and then come over to the panel and click Smooth Line. So in this case, there's only three to do. It doesn't take that long. With each line, you can also change things like the line color, the line thickness, the shadow types, whether you want it dotted or dashed or solid. All of those options are here, and you can play around with those at any stage. At this point, each line is just a simple line. There are no markers on the line. If you want to add markers, you come to the top here in the options. You switch from line to marker. And then go to marker options here. And as you can see, it's currently set to none. But if you choose, say, built-in, you can choose things like what shape you want. So square, diamond, triangle type markers. So let's maybe supersize it just for demonstration. So a size 10 square block. To change the color of the block, if you want to, go to fill here and choose any of these options. I suggest just keep it simple, maybe a solid fill. And down here, you can then choose the color. And that's really about it for line charts. Line charts are most effective when you've got lots of data to plot. So here we've only got 4 years, but let's say we had 20 years of data. That'd be a much better scenario for using a line chart. Often if you've got, say, 50 or 100 or several hundred bits of data, that's also a good option for using a line chart.
Thanks for watching. Go get them.